Hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make some basic plastic materials in Blender. We're going to be making a see-through and non-see-through plastic. It's fairly simple, so let's just get straight into it. As always, we're going to add a sphere for our object, so I'm just going to press Shift A. Under Mesh, I'm going to choose UV Sphere, and here you can see an Add UV Sphere. We can open this up and you can make this more subdivided if you like. I might just make this 64 by 32 for a bit more higher detail. There we are. And now I'll just right click it and I'm going to choose Shade Smooth. Then I'm going to left click and drag my timeline here, just pull up a little bit, and where the clock is, we can change it from timeline to shader editor. You can't see any material options here. It's probably because you're in the wrong mode of the shader editor. And see here, mine's set to line style for some reason. So I'm just going to left click this and change it back to object. Then the plus new will appear and I can just press plus new. Then I'm just going to call it plastic. And before we make any changes, we can't actually see anything. So let's go into our material preview, which is this option here. Right now, even though our base color is white, you can see our object is black. This is due to a setting which is off by default in the new EV in Blender 4.2. So to fix this issue, all I'm going to do is first come to my render properties here, which is this camera button, and I'm going to change from cycles to EV. You'll see there's a bunch of new settings in Blender 4.2 for the EV render engine, as it now has ray tracing features. We'll need to turn on this ray tracing to actually see our correct color. So I'm going to left click the box to turn on ray tracing, then I'll left click the arrow to expand the settings, and where it says max roughness, I'm going to change it from 0 to 1. Now you can see our material displays the correct color. For my plastic, I'm going to make it a nice blue color. So I'll just left click the base color and I'm just going to give it a nice blue. However, it doesn't really look like plastic, and that's because it's actually set to quite high roughness. Roughness isn't necessarily referring to making the surface more bumpy, but rather it's referring to the intensity of the reflections, which happens to be caused by the bumpiness or smoothness of a surface. If I made that explanation a little too complex, just think of it as the lower this roughness is, the more clear the reflections will be. This is because a less rough or smoother surface will have more visible reflections. I'm going to set my reflection to something like 0.05, so nice and reflective. You can see instantly, this looks a lot more reflective and more like a plastic. Now we're pretty much done here, but there's one extra thing we can do, and that's we can change our index of refraction for some extra realism. So the index of refraction for plastic is 1.46, and that will help us have just that extra tad of realism. If you want a list of some different IORs, I do have a free IOR guide, which you can download from my website for free. I'll leave the link in the description below. Now let's go ahead and make some see-through plastic. So I'm just going to left click my sphere and press Shift D. Then to move it along, I can just press G and then X to grab it and then move it along the X axis. Once I'm done, I'll just left click to save its position. Now if I was to edit this material here, it would edit both of them, so I need to duplicate this material. So here, there's a button here which is called New Material, and this just duplicates it. So I'll left click it, and you'll see its name is now being changed to plastic.001. I'm just going to left click that and call it Plastic See-Through. Then for this one, I'm going to make a nice red see-through plastic. So I'm going to change my base color to something a little bit more red. Now, to make this actual see-through, we need to change the transmission value. So here, there's a tab called transmission, and you can left-click the arrow to open up. Here, we have a parameter called weight, which is pretty much an on and off switch for making something transparent. So I'll change my weight to 1, and you can see now our plastic is now see-through. You might want to make the roughness a little bit smaller for the see-through one, so maybe I'll change it to 0.02. Awesome, and that just about covers it. You can of course add some extra roughness imperfections if you'd like, but I thought I'd just leave it for this video since I've covered that quite a lot. If you want to learn more about materials in Blender, I highly recommend checking out my free course, which will teach you all the fundamentals behind making materials in Blender. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a good day. Take care.